trapped at the border, the forlorn Hondurans hoping to reach the U.S. Dozens of Hondurans fleeing poverty and violence abandoned their efforts to cross through Mexico to the U.S. amid mounting fear and exhaustion, more than a week into the grueling journey north. As many as 4,000 Hondurans, including pregnant women and children, remain trapped at the Guatemala-Mexico border awaiting permission to continue the long journey to the U.S. The caravan of thousands started as 160 people 9 days ago, but its numbers have swelled as more have joined in an attempt to leave poverty and violence behind them. Now a minority have turned back, using transport organized by Guatemalan security forces. "I'm going back because I've had enough, and this might be my only chance to go back safely, guarded by policemen," said 17-year-old Byron Espina from Copán. Espina worked as a coffee picker in a small village called La Entrada, making only pennies, he said, and had hoped to find work in the U.S. Free buses started arriving late on Friday night, just hours after Mexican riot police had hurled tear gas bombs into the frustrated crowd after some migrants broke through a riot shield cordon to enter Mexican territory. Mexico's president, Enrique Peña Nieto, said on Saturday that the caravan of people could seek asylum or enter with the right travel documents, but irregular entry would not be tolerated. Fearing further repression and long delays, some started boarding the buses destined for the Honduran border town Aguacaliente, where police have stopped hundreds of migrants from leaving the country to join the exodus north. Trump threatens to close US Mexico border over Honduran migrant caravan. Read more. The escalating intervention by security forces is seen as a direct response to threats by President Trump to cut off millions of dollars of aid to Central America and Mexico if they fail to stop the caravan the second this year reaching the U.S. border. "Migration is not a crime, and a regional agreement allows free movement for citizens of Honduras, Guatemala, El Salvador, and Nicaragua traveling with national ID cards," the director of the Americas for Amnesty International, Erica Guevara Rosas, tweeted. "Honduran migrant caravan is not a security threat, but an act of survival by hundreds of people escaping extreme